Hey there, Mustangs. Welcome to school for the week of November 30th.
Let's start off the week with the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance. Ready? Begin.
I pledge allegiance
to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the Republic
for which it stands,
one nation under God,
indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. Job well done. Let's see what's happening at Westlake this week.
Thanks for the update. This week is Thanksgiving. Let's get more information.
Mustangs, this is the week. One of the best Westlake STEM traditions that we do every year is our annual Turkey Bowl. It will take place today during both lunches. Right outside on the field. Come, make sure you eat really quick because 10 minutes into lunch, we will begin the Turkey Bowl. This is a football game that we do. So we've got the pennies out. We're going to have an epic game, and we want to make sure that we get as many participants as would like to be involved. Just to give you a taste, I'm going to show you the highlight reel from last year. And of course, we'll be filming this year. So next week, we'll show you the highlights of the game that we play today. So you get back-to-back weeks of highlight reels of the Turkey Bowl at Westlake STEM. Look forward to seeing you at lunchtime.
Westlake Turkey Bowl 2019.
The kick is off!
I've
oh, it's a good one!
Plenty
it's a good
to
one!
Be thankful for.
All right, get him, guys! Get him! Pull his flag out! Get him!
I haven't
get him.
Got a great big yacht to sail.
No, wait, no. Oh,
short
get him right there!
Shore.
Get him right there!
Still I've got
one alligator, two alligator, three alligator, four alligator. Oh, he stole it! Oh, get him! Get him! Get
I've
him,
got
get him, get him, get him.
Plenty to be thankful for. No private car,
red
no caviar,
right
no carpet on my floor.
Hey,
still I've got
plenty there he goes, there he goes,
to be thankful
for. Go, 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 go! Lock for him, he's
got
good!
Eyes
oh.
To see with, ears to hear with, arms to hug with, lips to kiss with, someone to
the ball,
adore.
Run, 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 run. He's
got... How could
he
anybody
there he goes,
ask
there he goes.
For more?
Ben's looking, Ben's looking, Ben's looking.
My needs
oh,
are small. I buy
get
them
him,
all
him. Oh,
at the 5 and 10 cent store. Oh, I've got
there he goes, there he goes. Oh, it's a reverse.
To be thankful for.
Fourth down. Run, 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 run. Oh, no, get it up. Pick it up, pick it up. You get 4 Mississippi. 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi, 4 Mississippi. Get up. Get there. Get him. Get him. Get him. Get him. Get him. He's still up. He's still up. Oh, 2019 is underway.
Got eyes to see with, ears to hear with, arms to hug with, lips to kiss with.
Wow, so cool. Let's now get our weekly COVID code reminder.
Hi, Mighty Mustangs. This is Mrs. Luther. I'm here to remind you about our COVID code. Please eat in the designated areas, outside and in our dining halls. I really need your help to help keep everyone safe. And one way that we can do that is to refrain from taking our masks off. If you're eating in the hallway or in your classrooms, you're going to have to remove your mask a bit to get the food inside. Every time we remove our masks, it is spreading the germs. Please help me by keeping your masks on and only eating in the dining hall and outside. Thank you, guys. Have a great day.
Let's head to our counselors for an announcement.
Hey, Westlake family. Thank you. We hope you're finding many reasons to be thankful. This Monday, we're inviting students and staff to write thank you notes to the good people in their lives. Family members, teachers, administrators, lunch ladies, whoever.
We will be delivering 30 thank you cards to each classroom to be used during the first period on Monday. Just let us know if you need more.
Remember to ask for extra Mustang points for saying thank you in any language. And if you record your class saying thanks during first period in another language, you can compete to win a donut party. Mahalo.
Obrigada.
Gracias.
Shut up.
What? Yes. Wait.
Oh, he's going to be so embarrassed.
What makes you happy? Having fun? Hanging out with friends? Delicious food? Making money? Well, consider this. Psychologists have scientifically proven that one of the greatest contributing factors to overall happiness in your life is how much gratitude you show. Yeah? Think about that. Go ahead and marinate on it for a second. You can thank me later if you want. It'll make you feel better according to this study. You go ahead and click on it and read it if you want. Or you can keep watching because we read it and we thought it might be fun to test out for ourselves. We gathered a selection of volunteers to act as our subjects. First, we gave them a test. They didn't know what we were looking for, but it gave us a pretty good idea of their current level of happiness. We asked them to close their eyes and think of somebody who was really influential in their life, somebody who did something really amazing or important for them. We had them write down as much as they could about why this person was so important. Now, a lot of them thought at this point the experiment was over, until we really put them on the spot and tried to get them to call that person and read what they wrote about them. Thank you, Jessica. We're gonna have to have you call your mother. So who is that right person for you?
The person is my sister, Erica.
We're gonna give Erica a call.
Okay.
Who'd you end up picking?
Friend of mine, Craig Ains.
Her name is Dora.
My college accounting instructor.
Really? Mm-hmm. Is this somebody you're still in touch with today?
No, I'm assuming that he's passed on.
That's a shame.
To the great beyond.
You up for it?
Yes.
What would you say if we called up Dora?
Oh, well, we can try, but she lives in Britain.
In Britain?
Oh, no, never by heart, dude. This is awful.
That's fine. I don't know my mom's number by heart.
If it's true that those who are going on are looking down on us, maybe he read my chicken scratch.
Hey, sweetheart.
Hey, how you doing? You got a second? Where you at, in the hotel?
I am. I'm in the hotel. You scared me when you asked if I had a second or something's wrong.
No, I'm on this little TV show, and they told me to talk about the person that influenced me the most, and I picked you, they're making me call you.
Oh, wonderful!
Hi, Rich Craig. I'm not here right now.
At the tone, please record your message.
Oh, come on.
Hello?
Hi.
Hi.
Erica? It's me.
All right, so I got to read you this paragraph. Can you hear me?
Yes, I can. Go ahead, sweetheart.
All right. The person that influenced me the most would be my mother, Marlo Dawson. She is a single mother of two. She is a very hard worker and dedicated to her family.
Hey, Craig. This is Loie. This is going to be a funny little voicemail, so I hope you enjoy it.
I'm so sorry for calling you at 4 o'clock in the morning.
I have to read this to you, okay? And you can't say anything or, I don't know. You can respond, but I probably will just keep going. Okay?
Is everything okay?
Yes, but I have to read this out loud to you.
The person who has had the biggest impact on my life was my college accounting instructor. He had a joy and enthusiasm for his job like no other teacher I have ever known.
I love her to death, and she keeps me going with positive talk. She is a woman that knows what she wants and won't give up until it is achieved.
Oh, something. I don't know what I'm about to cry because it's so beautiful.
I have to say that this is just wonderful.
I first met Craig on an independent feature film set in Whitefish, Montana. I recently have been sending Craig a lot of positive thoughts as he's suffered a series of health problems. Despite his medical problems, he's continued to work and take pleasure in the small things in life, like sitting quietly with his wife Janine on the porch. Erica is my older sister and my best friend. Sometimes it even feels like we are twins. She's my number one fan and my number one supporter. She makes me happy because despite all my mistakes and my decisions, she still loves me no matter what.
Your friendship is everything. And you are one of the most important person in my life.
Even when she has a kid and many children, I will love her more than her kids. Okay, maybe not. I will never forget when she flew 3,000 miles at the drop of a phone call to save me from a breakup.
I'm being blessed by having a son like you. I love you.
Bye.
Before we let them go, we gave our subjects one more happiness test. Now, we mixed up and rephrased the questions so they didn't know they were taking the same test twice. For those who took the time to actually write something down but couldn't make the phone call for whatever reason, we saw happiness increase between 2 and 4%. Good, but not exactly mind-blowing. Now, for those who actually picked up the phone and personally expressed their gratitude, we saw increases between 4 and 19%. So either way, expressing your gratitude will make you a happier person. But you want to know something really interesting? The person who experienced the biggest jump in happiness was the least happy person who walked in the door. What does that mean? That means if you're having a particularly tough time, trying this out will more likely have a greater impact on you. Trust me. I'm in a lab coat. In fact, while you're at it, film it and upload it to us, and we'll do something awesome with it. I'm Julian, and this has been The Science of Happiness.
That's it for us. Thanks for watching.
This is Mustang Media.